Hello everyone, it's Vicky and I'm here today already focusing on what I want to talk about because I am so excited. I waited several weeks. I've been doing some research and I've been on a crazy traveler's notebook obsession. Okay, I'm just going to be straightforward with that. I love traveler's notebooks. I love everything stationary, but I get on these kicks. And lately it's been for traveler's notebooks, but not like just the regular size traveler's notebooks, not the A5 traveler's notebooks, but more unique sizes, as well as from companies I've never ordered from, and also that I've only once ordered from. And I have a video coming up from a company I've never ever heard of, and I've been super inspired to order from them. So the first one I'm going to talk about is from Speckled Fawns. This is the kind of huggable, the nubuck huggable leather. This is in the A6 size. So I'll do a size comparison, of course, for you in just a minute to show you and just kind of give you leather comparisons as well. The reason why I like to do this is because I really like to shed light on all the different traveler's notebooks that are out there. I love how unique people get with traveler's notebooks. I like to see what they come up with. I like all the different leathers, and that's really why I love to kind of really do my research with these. I can't get enough of them. I get asked the question still very much repeatedly, how do I manage this many notebooks? And honestly, I only have about 1 to 2, maybe 3 that are fully active at one time. And then the rest just kind of get switched out. That's the beauty of these, is that you can change them out because the covers can be changed out and the inserts can all kind of stay the same. To be truthful, whenever I get a new planner or I get a new traveler's notebook, I really like to just set it up fresh start. Sometimes I'll bring in a notebook from another planner, but I usually really just like a fresh start. It's just a really nice way to kind of get your creative juices going, and that's usually what I primarily use my traveler's notebooks for, are just really jotting down, journaling, things like that. I still have a very hard time just to strictly use this as a planner for some reason. I always go back to the rings, and I have shown you I use the A6 Gilio for that, and I love that just for my planning, but for this, more of like the memory keeping and all of that kind of stuff. So without further ado, this is an A6 Speckled Fawn. It is in a beautiful like olive color. Now the leather on this is very, 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 very soft. It's almost like fluid, and it's very almost like furry feeling. The color that's showing up is pretty true to color, that beautiful olive color. This charm is just a fantasy charm that I picked up at Hobby Lobby and tied it to a leather cord. I still need to get a bead for the end on this end, and I just kind of hang it over the inserts so that it keeps my place in certain places. But this actually has little pages. Isn't it adorable? It's really cute. So you, with Speckled Fawns, they are in Illinois, which is awesome because I'm in Illinois. Terry is behind the beautiful company, and she's got a Facebook group, which I will of course link down below. That's really kind of where I saw a lot of these guys, as well as kind of the infamous like thicker spine that a lot of folks use with Speckled Fawns that I've noticed. People can get a very thick spine so they can really truly stuff your notebooks if that's someone who you are, that you really like to stuff your traveler's notebooks. I also was very much intrigued because the leathers look so unique. The smell from this is so wonderful and so intoxicating. If you love that leather smell, it really truly is. Comes packaged beautifully. I did have a little bit of a delay in regards to like shipping, but she was kind enough, Terry was kind enough to waive my shipping fees, and it got sent to me relatively quickly after that. So customer service, I've had firsthand experience. It goes very smoothly. I had no issues getting in touch with Terry, none of that. The elastic closures on here are a little bit on the not as kind of tight side, and I'll show you what I mean in just a minute, but I think the only thing I need to do is just to kind of tighten them up a little bit, because I noticed that with the inside as well, they're just very, very elasticy, for lack of a better word. So I'm just going to have to tighten those up a little bit. I like my inserts to be really nice and snug and tight. On the inside here, you can see that there are some just really beautiful pockets, great stitching, beautiful stitching. Terry was kind enough to include a couple of little notebooks and things like that inside of here, which is really, really great. This is almost like, again, a suede on the inside. This leather is, I mean, you can literally roll it You know, I mean, it's just such a soft suede-like leather. It's amazing. I don't think I've touched anything quite like this before. I thought it was very similar just because of the pebbliness to the Naked Cow flapjack, but it's actually not. The flapjack isn't as, like, suedey, and neither is the Cherry Ice, which is a Napa leather from the Naked Cow. Those two are very soft, but different in feel, where this one is very kind of, it's suede. It feels like suede. It's not, it's leather, but it feels like suede. Hugs your inserts very nicely. You know, if you really are like that type of person that loves that kind of feeling of a soft and almost furry feel, you're gonna love these. Now, inside here, I have A6 Midori notebooks. I found these on Amazon. I love the Midori MD notebooks. They take the fountain pen pretty well. And I just like the little grid lines in there. They lie relatively flat and it's just nice. I really like the A6 size. They come with a couple of different stickers. I'll have a link down below for where I got them on Amazon. And then Terry included this guy, a personal note to me also. And then this is so awesome. She included this as well. Isn't that awesome? The Oz passport. I have to actually look this up more. On the back here, when I looked, it says www.philosophersguild.com. So I have to look and see if I can find more of these because this is just awesome. Look at how cool that is. Isn't that so awesome? And I know that Terry came out with like a limited edition emerald green kind of traveler's notebook that is like Oz inspired. And I kind of want to get my hands on that, but I haven't had a chance to. And then here is the Speckled Fawns business card right there. So beautiful notebook. The smell of this is just absolutely stunning, honestly, for lack of a better word. It's stunning. The work, the craftsmanship is beautiful on this, and I really love the A6 size. There's a ton of options to choose from in that regard of sizes, so if you're someone who really wants some customability, you'll find that on the Speckled Fawns website. And in regards to like price, I think it is extremely fairly priced with everything that's been out on the market. I don't think she's upped any of her prices where she really kind of could if she wanted to, but I think they're in a really fair bracket. Like, I think this was in like between $43 and $46, and she waived the shipping fee for me, which was like $3 or $4, being that I'm in Illinois. But you know, it's not something that's like over the top where I think it's like just too expensive. Actually, none of the ones that I got today are, I think, are like just extremely expensive. But I love this size. I love the A6 size. Let me grab a regular, more regular sized one. These are from Naked Cow, and these are like the regular size Midori that is a little bit with a little bit more room. So I could just give you an idea of what an A6 size is. So you can see here, basically an A6 size is if you took like a legal piece of paper, folded it in half, that becomes an A5, folded that A5 in half, that's about the A6 size, just to give you an idea. And I like that size because I feel like when I make my own inserts, I'm not wasting papers. And so that's why I really like A6 size. It's a great like portable size, and it's wide enough, you know, from when you're writing, that it really works very, very nicely in the A6 size. And I'm very, very happy with this size. So this is from Speckled Fawns. I'll have links and everything down below. Next up, I have the Sojourner from Retrochers. Rowena is the owner, and I quickly fell in love with her several months back. I want to say like in February or March, with this guy right here. And I found her on Instagram and just was like just fascinated by Rowena. She's not only like just very artistic and creative, but she also does a lot of mission work. And she was taking a lot of the monies that she was making from making these traveler's notebooks and putting them towards other people's mission work. And so I was very touched by that. I thought it was really great. And also just how unique this is. So this is a B6 slim size. I have a full review on this guy, which I will link down below so you can see that. I also added a beautiful pineapple charm that I believe I got from Mrs. Brimble's from one of her boxes. It has a really nice weight to it. It's just a beautiful like three-dimensional solid gold looking pineapple. It's not real gold, but you know what I mean. And so Rowena came up with these B6 slim size, and I was just enamored with it because I love B6, and then the fact that they're slim is just, you know, the icing on the cake. So these little, she had included this little folder, or I might have ordered it last time, I can't remember exactly, but there's a little folder you can purchase. And then Rowena has her own inserts that you can purchase. So if you're concerned about getting the B6 Slim or where you would find those types of inserts, you can find them on her shop, but you can also find them relatively quickly on most Etsy shops. And then these idea notebooks, I believe you can find on other shops as well online. I'll see if I can find some and link them for you, but I just purchased these from Rowena. So I love these because they're filled with Tomo River paper and they have a small grid, and they also have a little like gridded off section right here that I tend to kind of use as a like date marker or a header for different types of like note ideas, like a YouTube video idea. So I can find things a little bit more quickly that way in the notebook, and they're just great. And I order the craft because I like working on craft paper just to put, this is from Dee Dee Willingham. This is one of her ATC cards that I put in there. So I love this size, and Rowena had gotten some new leathers and I was very curious. And of course I went and purchased another one, and this is in her seed type of leather. And this leather is, again, I think I'm just on this kick with this really soft leather. This is that same kind of furry almost leather where you, if you run your finger over it, you can almost see the leather kind of changing a little bit. You could see that it just, it looks like suede. I really love the red thread. I mentioned that when I was unboxing these naked cows. I love the red thread. I don't know why, there's just something about it. And I love how the red looks on the camel color. I just think it looks really beautiful. I also started making a charm here. It's just a little bottle, glass bottle with a map inside of there. And then I need to get a couple more beads to add, excuse me, to the bottom of that. This is awesome, by the way. This is a Midori pen that I found on Amazon. I'll link it down below. And it's all brass. And so what's awesome about this is it, A, will patina over time just for my hands. The brass will. It doesn't smell like leather. I know people were concerned about like a metal smell on your hands after using this. It's not there. There's a good amount of weight, and it uses the Pilot G2 ink refills. So if you're a fan of the Pilot G2, kind of that gel pen, that's the refills that go into this pen, and I love it. I love the brass. I really wanted a weighty pen. I'm very, very happy with this pen. So inside of the B6, this one I opted to get with stitching. So it's a little bit different from this guy. This one I just kind of got a raw just to see what it's like. This one has beautiful stitching around. Again, very, very under the radar. It looks very well like blended. It's not easy to see in real life. I don't know if you can see it a bit more in the viewfinder when I'm looking at it, but in real life it just really nicely blends and works very nicely. And I say that because if you didn't like how the white stitching looks, like the contrast of this, you can see that this is just a little bit smaller of a stitching and just kind of blends a little bit more into the traveler's notebooks than you would see here. I love both looks. I'm not saying one is better than the other. I love both. But if you were someone who thought, wow, I don't like seeing this stitching, but I do like the finished polished look of that, this could be an option here for you. Rowena also has her little like signature for the Sojourners down here. So that comes on the notebooks. And on the back here, you can just see it's just that real beautiful leather. This leather is very soft, very pliable. Hugs your inserts very, very nicely. I'm very happy to see how this will kind of wear with time. And the leather difference with this guy versus this is just plush. Like it is just almost like a pillow, like you're holding onto a pillow. Like if you were to fall asleep with this, you'd be cozy, you'd be comfy. If you were to fall asleep with this, you'd be not as cozy and comfy as this is the best way I can describe that. So inside, I got a little pocket, which comes kind of with the configuration of getting the stitching. It's just kind of a secretarial pocket where you can just stick things in there, as well as like a little credit card pocket for those folks that like kind of maybe want to put a credit card in here, maybe throw some cash in here, or even the decorative folks who really like to maybe put a paper clip in there or something of that nature. It's nice. I like keeping my Hobonichi Weeks in here. The Hobonichi Weeks for me acts as a memory keeper slash, you know, a place to have a calendar type of a thing. It fits really nicely in that B6 slim size. I love the Tomo River paper. I love throwing my recipes in the back here with the, because there's 75 pages worth of notes in the back here. So I like having recipes from Jenny Penton, which I'll have linked down below. She has a lot of great recipe ideas. Everything I've made from her website has been delicious, and it's all kind of like made from scratch, so I feel like I'm doing my motherly slash wifely duties because it's just great. So I have my Hobonichi Weeks in there. then these I ordered from Rowena, and these are a dot grid still with the Tomo River paper inside. And I believe Rowena said that these are the new papers that she's making now with her inserts. So it's a little bit of a heftier, I believe, Tomo River paper. So you won't see quite as much shadowing with this paper that you would with like the real, real thin Tomo River paper like you would with this guy, where you do see a fair bit of shadowing. So not bleed through, nothing bleeds through, but you do see a fair bit of shadowing because it's so thin. This is extremely thin paper, where with this paper you're getting a little bit more, it's still Tomo River, but it's a little bit thicker, so you don't have to worry that much about the shadowing. And I ordered a monthly because this is what her monthly looks like. So for something this portable, I shared, I don't love having it as a planner, but if I have this in my bag with me and I need it for, you know, if I drop my daughter off at camp or at school or dance or whatever, and I need a calendar, I have something. Right now, right for the moment, I'm using my Hobonichi Weeks, but I wanted to have the refill just to see what they look like. And then I also love just the dot grid, and I have several others of the idea notebook that I shared that was in here. I have three or four more of those that I ordered from Rowena as well. So that's what's inside of this notebook. I haven't played fully with this paper yet, but I am excited to see what the quality looks like. But just from feeling it, it's still very thin and very lightweight. It's just I can tell already it's not going to be showing your artwork quite as much. And I'm assuming, since Rowena does, if you don't follow her Instagram, you should. She does a lot of like inspirational journal work and puts on some watercolors and things like that. You'll be able to see what I mean in regards to like it not allowing the shadowing to really kind of come through on the paper. But I love how this feels in the hand. It feels so comfortable. It feels like that very like worn, you know, this is meant to be in my hands type of a thing. I love this B6 slim size. So once again, let me show you next to an A6 size. So this is from Speckled Fonts, A6, B6 slim. And then next to a Midori kind of regular size, standard size, with a little bit of extra space on the side, just to give you an idea. Okay, so for those folks that are looking for that more like portable type of planning or that portable journaling, these are kind of the choices I go with. It's very hard for me to go into the field notes and the pocket size, and I think it's because it's so like narrow, or with these it's narrow, but you have a little bit more space to work with. I know that's really weird of me to say that and very kind of picky, but that's my personal preference. So that's why I'm showing you these types of notebooks. So these are the two from Sojourner, and I will share the links down below so you can get your own if you are interested. Now, in regards to working with Rowena and her, like, just the customer service is phenomenal. She's a super nice person. She does Periscope videos, very easy with questions or anything of that nature. With shipping, if you follow her on Instagram, you'll be able to see if she's traveling with any kind of mission work or if she's doing anything of that nature. So that could give you a little bit of an idea of how long it may take to get your notebook. I know I had ordered when she was on vacation, so I waited about a week or so. Not very long to have to wait, but it's great if you follow these folks on their social media so you get an idea of what's happening, as well as if you're following in the Facebook groups. It gives you an idea of what people are using them for, how they're using them, and things of that nature. So I always recommend following them in that regard. But these two are, again, from the Sojourner USA website. And last but not least, I just received this morning, and I was waiting for this, even though it did not take very long to get here. It really did not. But this was my last kind of purchase, and this was the last one that I wanted to include for this video. This came from PelleStudio, and it is coming from overseas, and I was just beyond thrilled to finally kind of pull the trigger and purchase what I have inside of here. I was also amazed that when you select the expedited shipping on the website for this came within like 2 or 3 days. So when PelleStudio posted on Etsy that my shipment, that it had shipped, that was like on a Friday. I got this on Monday morning, which I thought was amazing. Coming from overseas is just it blew my mind away. It really did. So inside of here, PelleStudios is an Etsy shop. They are overseas, and they have some really beautiful traveler's notebooks in a lot of like the more unique colors that you don't see very often. And that's why I was very intrigued by the company. I wanted to see what they had to offer, and they had colors that I hadn't seen really anywhere else or could get my hands on. The company itself, I have to say, I am blown away with how well they worked with me. So, I mean, as soon as I placed my order, no joke, I had someone contacting me, asking me questions about what I wanted size-wise, and made sure that I was happy with the sizes that they were cutting the leather. I think I had like 10 interactions because they kept asking, you know, are you okay with this? Would you like this? Would you like that? Amazing in that regard. Amazing with getting back to you in questions. I mean, I think I waited like, I don't know, 2 minutes and I had a response. It was unbelievable. And it was like late at night, I got a quick response. The next day, during the day, I got a quick response. So it was phenomenal in that regard. Again, phenomenal with how quickly it came with the expedited shipping. I don't know how long it takes without the expedited shipping, but with expedited shipping, from the time that I placed this order to it arriving at my front door is about a week and a half, if that, which is amazing. So inside, let's take a quick look. You get this, it came with this beautiful sack. It came with some extra goodies. So she put in, I want to say it's a she, it could be he, but I think it's a she, put in some stickers, which I love getting stickers from other countries. I don't know why, but I love it and I cherish them very, very much. So I got stickers. Don't worry, I'll get to the notebooks, but I just want to show the extra goodies that were put in here. I got a pencil case. Isn't that awesome? This really pretty pencil case I got. I think it's just so pretty. I ordered the clips. I ordered these guys. I really like these kind of ghost binders. I think that's what they call them. The ghost binder clips. I like them a lot. I think they're just really pretty. Functional but very pretty, and I ordered a couple of those, and then I got extra elastics. Isn't that nice? I got extra elastics with my order. So, and I got them in different colors. Okay, in here, little baggie. I don't think I ordered this, but I got an extra charm, and I believe everyone's order comes with a charm. Like, you can pick what charm you want to go with it. But isn't that so darling? It's like a little leather tassel. And then here's like a little crystal ball with a flower. That's so cute. I just couldn't get over how adorable all these little items were. And then a little envelope for a paperclip. This is like, it looks like a little leaf and a little reindeer head. Just look at that. How cute. Oh, it's easier for me to show you on there. So you can see how adorable are those. So those were extra little goodies. But I think you get one of these with all of your order. So next, what I'm so beyond excited about are the little pens that were included. So I love when companies, I'm a sucker for extra goodies. I'm just going to put that out there. I am. I think most people are, because I think the way that you feel is you feel like you're spending a fair bit of money on these traveler's notebooks. And so when a company kind of acknowledges that and says, here's a few more extra goodies, it makes the customer happy. Like, I definitely see the business like tactic behind that. It just does. It makes you feel so much better because you're thinking, oh my gosh, I got free stuff along with my order. So I totally fall into that category. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Okay. So what they added in here, it says Twinkling Stars. It's a beautiful pen, but my heart leapt out of my chest yesterday when I saw this. It's a fountain pen, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, it is a fountain pen. It's a tiny little fountain pen, and it has a little cartridge filler. Amazing, right? I like just blew a gasket yesterday. I wanted to fill it so badly and start using it, but I waited. I wanted to film this. And then this pen came with also just this beautiful, like, glittery little thing to kind of keep. I mean, isn't it so pretty? Everybody likes sparkle. Then what do we get in here? All right, first one I'm going to show you was a no-brainer purchase. Oh, and another little pen. So three little pens. Then the next purchase, and I went on the website and just double checked to make sure what was included in your order, and you do get a charm. So for sure the charm came with the order. I also noticed on the website that they do have two tones, which I have actually on my wish list. It's in my cart. I just haven't purchased it yet. I do have on my wish list to get a two-tone traveler's notebook because I love what I got in this package. So, came packaged like this, okay, inside. This is like the beautiful peachy pink color. There's a name. It's like Sakura Blossom or something like that. You do get a little leather tag that comes with your traveler's notebook. So one thing I do think that the benefit of having this is if you were to thread this through, you can actually hang like a pen off of this if you wanted to. The color of this is, again, amazing. It's just such a beautiful color. Let me just show you that beautiful, like, just pinky peach color. And if you were to get this two-tone, you can get it inside a different color. I mean, just check out the website. You'll see when I'm talking about when I say the two-tone. It's just you can get, like, a turquoise inside, you know, and a pink exterior. The leather smells beautiful. It's very thin. It's not heavy at all. This is in the B6 size. I really am a huge fan of the B6. I really am. I have a ZenCraft Old Man Comfort that I'll share with you. Here's the ZenCraft Old Man Comfort in the B6 size. So this Old Man Comfort is from ZenCraft. It is the notebook that I just have fallen in love with this size. It's just an amazing size. The thing with it, it's a little bit of a heavier leather. It's so beautiful, though. I love this so very much. And, you know, it's a work of art. And that's where I really fell in love with the B6 size. So that's why I went with a couple of more B6s because, you know, I love traveler's notebooks. This is extremely lightweight, very pliable, as you can see. I love that they added these little pockets in here that you can stick little cards, little paper clips. I mean, it's a lovely piece of work. They reached out to me and asked me how many strings I wanted, if I wanted two, if I wanted four. I really, really loved and appreciated that. You can customize your stitching around. You can have stitching. You don't have to have stitching. You can put a pen loop in there. I mean, just endless options. I do love that they included the extra elastic so that I'm kind of thinking this darker pink will look really beautiful across the traveler's notebook. I'm just so in love. I just love what I got. I wasn't sure what I was getting just because I saw some people say about some of the leathers that it was like a faux leather, which I don't have a problem with faux leather, but I would prefer a real leather traveler's notebook. But I'm excited to see how this will patina. It's a very smooth leather. So what first came to my mind when I was holding this is the bay leather from Foxy Fix. If you're familiar with the bay leather, it is kind of that same feeling of a very kind of soft, almost suede-y type of leather that I'm thinking will put, like, just get a darker pink is what I'm assuming will happen to this notebook, is it will just take on the oils, and if you bring it outside, the sun and everything, I think it'll just make it into a beautiful pink color. It's gorgeous. And in the viewfinder, it looks a little more pastel-y pink, but in real life, it's a gorgeous, gorgeous pink color. So of course, because it's coming from Hong Kong, I thought, well, I should just order two. Why not, right? So I did. And this one came packaged like this. Now this one I'm really, really, really excited about, and the reason for that is this is a new leather, and it's called the Wax Jeans. So basically it's like a blue jean color, like your blue jeans, like the pants. There's a wax on it. The wax will start to wear off and give it that like stonewashed color, which I cannot wait. I am just so excited to see that happen. You can feel the wax on there, and you can kind of see how the little like stonewash is coming through with something like this. There's some scratches on there, and you can see like my fingernail when it does that. It scratches off the wax that's on top of it, and it'll give it like just a really cool, a lot of character type of a notebook, but still very beautiful. Like this color is so gorgeous, and you can feel that like wax that's on there, which is really cool to feel with your hands. And I love the look of blue jeans. I do. I love that, like, just that again, that story that it tells, that it's yours, it's something you are creating by holding it and working in it, and I just love that. The inside is very simple. I've got my stitching in here. beautiful leather. I'm really excited to use this. I went with the bright colors because I don't have a lot of bright colors in my collection. I tend to kind of stick with the more neutral colors, but I thought the bright colors would be absolutely stunning for the summer, the spring, you know, or even in the winter time. Sometimes you just need a little pick-me-up and you want a little bit of color added in your life. And so I really wanted that, but I'm so pleasantly surprised with these notebooks at the quality and the fact that they're so nice and lightweight, but they smell so good. They smell like just wonderful leather products, and I'm thrilled. I'm very thrilled. I'm speechless. I wasn't sure what I was going to get because I didn't see reviews online that were like extremely positive for the company. So I might have looked at the wrong reviews. I could have not looked at enough. I don't know, but I have just positive things to say. I'm very, very happy with everything that I received from the company. I really and truly am. A couple of tips that I want to share with you when I am researching traveler's notebooks is I always follow the companies on the social media and try and see if they have Facebook groups. The reason why I do this is because for me, these traveler's notebooks are pieces that I want in my life forever. I don't usually, I've never sold a traveler's notebook. I hold on to them. They all come with a story, and then as they continue their life with me, they continue their story. And so that's why a lot of times I love looking and following a company, because I like to know where my notebooks are coming from. I love seeing all the inspiration, and I like to see who the creator is behind these traveler's notebooks. So for example, with like Speckled, Fawn, which is this little guy, you can see the A6 size compared to the B6 size. You can see it's a lot smaller. But I love, you know, the idea, like Terry is very involved in her Facebook group. So if you go to the Facebook group, there are people who are just so in love with these notebooks, and you can watch how they fill them, how they draw in them, how they plan in them. And it gives you an idea of like just the love that people have for these notebooks. And if it's something that you kind of look at on the website and it's not tickling your fancy, if it's not, you know, making your heart sing, then it may not be for you. And so I say this because I hate seeing orphan traveler's notebooks. Like, it's so sad to me when I see people constantly, like, you know, exchanging or getting rid of notebooks. And, you know, I just think that if you look at, and I'm not saying that there's anything wrong, and I'm not judging people. I'm just saying that I personally, to help me not have notebooks that I give away or feel unsatisfied with, is because I really love to follow first on social media and see where they're coming from. I'm not very impulsive when it comes to buying. It's very rare for me to kind of just jump and be like, oh my God, I need that right away immediately, without me kind of sleeping on it, following it on social media, learning about it, seeing if there's a story behind it. And that's really kind of where I will come in and purchase something. So I really loved these because I had been following Speckled Fawns for a while, like a long time, and just at first I wasn't drawn to the super chunky spines, but then when I saw this leather on there, I had to have this in my life. I wanted something so much like this, and I love how it feels, and I'm extremely happy with it. With the Sojourner, with this guy right here, now when I first saw the B6 slim size, I was very enamored with that idea, but then I started following Rowena on her Instagram and also through on YouTube and Periscope, and you can see her joy and how she uses her notebooks. So you can see that she fills it with art, she fills it with travels. You can see why she goes with this size, why this size works for her. And a lot of times that really helps me to feel very inspired when I'm holding and when I'm using this journal. It helps me to kind of hone in and tune into folks who are the creators of these. You know, they're the mastermind behind it. And what is their story? What are they, why did this come to life? What made this come to life? And I love that because it already starts off with a little beginning chapter of a life, and then now it's in my hands and it starts its journey of forever with me. And I just adore that. That's why I really love these notebooks. It's just that they are a best friend to me. And that can sound silly to folks, and I'm sure some people are laughing at that, but these really are. These are something that I love and cherish very much. They keep a lot of my heart in them, a lot of memories for me, and that's why I really love these traveler's notebooks. with these little guys, I went more with like just the idea of it being bright and colorful and fun. But I also really loved the company and how much passion they have for these guys. You know, they were very passionate about making these notebooks. They were reaching out to me to make sure that I was getting something I'm going to love. How many elastics I wanted, if I wanted the stitching, what colors, all of that. And the fact that the company is so driven to ask me if this is what I wanted made me feel like these are notebooks that they're creating for people to have for life, for people to bond with and to be best friends with. And that's the way that I look at journals and I look at these traveler's notebooks, is it's not just a cover for me. It's something that I go to because I'm comforted by. I like to hold it. I like to keep it with me. It brings me comfort and it brings me a lot of happiness to have these in my life. So that's just my one tip for you if you are looking for traveler's notebooks, is to really see where they come from, follow them on social media, and see what makes your heart sing. You know, it's very easy to fall into the whole Instagram thing and be in love with one person's picture, you know, and then want to purchase it, where you really want to make sure your heart's in it and you want that in your life. So that's my only tip for you. I hope you enjoyed all my kind of more unique traveler's notebooks and from shops that are a little maybe not as well known in the traveler notebook community. So I hope you check them out and see what they have to offer. Let me know if you've purchased from these companies, if you're happy with what you've gotten, if you feel like I need to check out some other companies, because I love researching and getting inspired by different companies. I will have one more video coming up very soon when I receive a traveler's notebook I've been waiting for a little while, that I've been extremely touched by, and I will have that video coming up very soon. I also have a website if you want to check out my website. I have more up close photos of all these beautiful traveler's notebooks, and I talk about it a little bit more in depth. So check out MissVickyBee.com, and I will see you all again very soon. Take care. Bye bye.